Welcome to this video lecture. In the last video lecture, we have studied about the state space. State space model of sensor system and state space model of MIMO system, single input, single output system. And we also studied the state space model of MIMO system. In general, what is the state space model equation? In the last video lecture, we derived in general the state model equations are given by capital X dot of t is equal to A into capital X of t plus B into capital U of t, you can write. And also Y of t is equal to C into capital X of t plus D into U of t. So these two are the state model equations for multiple input, multiple output system. And even you can apply the same thing for single input, single output system. Only when this D into U of t term goes to zero, then that equation becomes state model for single input, single output system. So this is the equation you need to remember and use for solving the problems. Assume that if any problem is given, and if a electrical circuit is given, and for that circuit you need to represent the equations in the form of a state space model. In the other chapters of control systems, you have studied that if a electrical network is given, how to find the transfer function for the given electrical circuit. Or if a mechanical network is given, how to find the transfer function of the mechanical network. You have studied all those things in the previous chapters. Now in this video lecture, you are going to study if a electrical network, let us limit ourselves for electrical network. If a electrical network is given, how to find its state space model. So instead of finding the transfer function for the given electrical network, as we have studied already in the previous chapters of control systems, in this video lecture, we will study how to find a state space model for the given electrical network. Okay, so the problems, let us do some one or two problem in this video lecture, where we are going to understand how to draw and how to get the state space model for a given electrical network or a given electrical circuit. You know that control system can be either by using transfer function method or by using state space model method. Either you can do the control system design and analysis using transfer function method, or you can do the design and analysis of the control system using state space model method. That's why we already came to know how to analyze and design for a given electrical system, how to get the transfer function. Now we will see for a given electrical network how to get the state space model. Now there are certain rules which you need to remember, rules or the procedure to find state space model. Procedure to find state space model given electrical circuit. This procedure is particularly for electrical network. So in the problem, if a electrical circuit is given, what are the procedures or the steps you need to follow to get the state space model of the given electrical network? The first step is to select the inductor current and capacitor voltage as your state variables. Your circuit, whatever they give in the problem, contains resistor, inductor, capacitor, voltage source and many other things. And in this network, in this electrical network, you have to select inductor current and capacitor voltage as your state variables only. Okay, so and after selecting your inductor current and capacitor voltage as state variables, so if there are two inductors, then you will get two state variables. If there are one inductor and one capacitor, you will get again two state variables. If there are two inductor and one capacitor, then you are going to get three state variables like this. So the number of state variables in the given electrical network will be equal to the total number of inductors and capacitors in the given network. And after selecting inductor current and capacitor voltage as state variables, second step is to apply KVL to the loops. Whatever the loops you have, you apply KVL. And after applying KVL, you have to simplify. You have to simplify to get in the forum like this. After applying KVL, the equations you need to simplify to get in this type of form, like x dot is equal to ax plus bu, y is equal to cx plus du, like this. So your state variables should be equal to some a into x. X means again state variables. X dot means, you know, dot represents differentiation. So x dot means differentiation of state variables should be equal to a into x plus some b into u. U stands for input signal. Okay, y. Next, y stands for output signal. Y should be equal to some c matrix into x. X means state variable plus some d matrix into u, input. So you have to, after applying KVL, you have to simplify so that you will get the expression like this. So that simplification steps in your problem is only a little bit bigger. Now the third step, after simplification, whatever the equations you have got, those equations you have to write it in the format of state space model, like a matrix format you have to write. Okay, so once you get x dot equation and y equation, you have to write those two equations in the form like a state space model. And that matrix form itself represents the state space model of your given electrical network. For that state space model, you can even write the signal flow graph at the end. So finally, you started with electrical network. You converted that electrical circuit into state space model. From that state space model, you can write the equation of your state space equation. And from that, you can write the signal flow graph. Whatever you got in the previous chapters of control system, same signal flow graph you can get using state space model. Consider this problem a numerical. Obtain the state space model for the circuit shown below. Take Vs as input and Ix as output. There is one circuit given, one inductor, one capacitor, one resistor is there. The current flowing in the resistor is called as Ix, and the input voltage is called supply voltage Vs. So you have to take this Vs as input itself and the current flowing in the resistor Ix as output. That will be mentioned in the given problem itself. Which one you have to take as input and output, that will be given in the problem. Now I will start working here. So in the first solution, what I have to take? So we have to first select my inductor current and voltage of the capacitor as your state variables. So there are two loops present here, first mesh and second mesh. I am going to call this loop 1 current as I1 and I am going to call the loop 2 current as I2. So I1 is the current flowing in the first loop and I2 is the current flowing in the second loop. So can I tell I1 is the same current flowing in the inductor? Yes. And I2 is the current flowing in the capacitor? Yes. What is the voltage across capacitor they have given in the problem? V. V stands for voltage across the capacitor, C. Capacitor, inductor, resistor values are not given. So now first we have to write down which is your input variable. So which is your input variable? They have told in the question that input is Vs. And in our control system, input is taken as U. Okay, especially in state space model, the input is taken as U. So I am calling, instead of Vs, I am calling it as U. Now what is output? Output in the problem, they have told that you have to take Ix current as the output. So in control system, we are going to take Y as my output. So U is input and Y is your output, especially in state space model. Now what are the state variables I am going to take? See, as I told in the previous procedure itself, the state variables should be equal to the inductor current and the capacitor voltage. Wherever inductor is there, you have to take that current as the state variable x1. Wherever capacitor voltage is there, that you have to take it as state variable x2. So how many state variables you will get in this problem? There is one inductor, one capacitor. So totally there are two energy storing elements, inductor and capacitor. So the number of state variables will be equal to the total number of inductor and capacitor present. So because there are two energy storing elements, inductor and capacitor. Therefore, I am going to get state variable x1 and state variable x2. X3 you will not get, only two state variables you will get. Now x1, I am going to take the state variable x1 as the inductor current L. Okay, always you have to take the current in the inductor as the state variable and voltage in the capacitor as the state variable. Now what is the current in the inductor in the circuit? I1. So I am going to take x1 as the state variable is equal to I1, inductor current. I1 stands for inductor current. Now x2 is the second state variable. Always you have to take the voltage of the capacitor as the state variable. What is voltage of capacitor? V. It is given in the question. So I am going to take x2 is equal to V. X2 is equal to V, which is nothing but voltage of capacitor or capacitor voltage. Now after mentioning which is input, which is output, now start applying KVL. So I will apply KVL to first loop. So if I apply KVL to first loop, you know how to apply KVL. So minus Vs plus inductor voltage. How to write inductor voltage? L into di1 by dt plus voltage across resistor R. You are going to get it as I1 minus I2. Okay, because resistor R is in common between two loops. So you will get R into current of first loop minus current of second loop. Now you substitute whatever. This is your KVL equation what you got. Now substitute the input, output, everything. So Vs is nothing but input plus U, L, D, I1. I1 is nothing but X1, state variable, DT, plus R. I1 is nothing but again X1. I2 you don't know. What is I2? That you don't know. So that you keep it as it is. Now if you multiply, what you will get? Minus U plus L into. Differentiation of x1 can be called as x1 dot. Single differentiation of x1 can be called as x1 dot. Plus R into x1 minus R into I2 is equal to 0. Now take x1 on the RHS. Sorry, take x1 on the LHS. Remaining everything you take it on the RHS. So LX1 dot is equal to plus U minus Rx1 plus Ri2. Now similarly I will get x1 dot is equal to, first I will write x1 term minus Rx1 I will write, then I will write plus Ri2, then I will write plus U, and this L is there, no? That L will come to the denominator, R by L, R by L, U by L. Okay, now here it should be always in which form? Please remember, whatever you do, the equations should be in the x dot is equal to a into x plus b into u. It should be of this form. So is it of this form? No. X dot is on the left hand side. And on the right hand side, you should have only capital X. Capital X means x1, x2. But instead of x2, you have I2. I don't know what is I2. So I have to replace this I2 with some other value. So in the next step I should replace, instead of this I2 I should replace with something else. So for that I am going to apply KVL to the second loop. So what is second loop? You have second loop is R into I2 minus I1 and plus V is equal to 0. Okay, voltage drop across resistor, R into I2 minus I1 plus V is equal to 0. V is the voltage across capacitor. So I am going to get here as plus R into I2 minus I1 plus V is equal to 0. Now substitute R into I2, I don't know, keep it as it is. I1 means X1, state variable. V means what? V means the second state variable x2, that also you substitute. So V is nothing but second state variable x2 is equal to 0. Now can you find I2 here? So I2 is nothing but what? Plus Rx1 minus x2 divided by R divided by R. Okay, so I2 is given by, if you simplify, you'll get I2 is equal to r are cancel, x1 minus x2 by r. So now I got to know this I2 value. This I2 value you can substitute in your equation number 1. Okay, in your equation 1 I2 was unknown, no? So I will substitute the equation I2 in equation number 1. So now what happens if you substitute? So your equation 1 will become x1 dot is equal to minus r by l x1 plus r by l. If you substitute I2, you will get x1 minus x2 by r plus u by l. So now what happens if you simplify? You will get minus r by l x1 plus r by l x1 minus x2 by l plus u by l. So the first term will be cancelled. So remaining will be minus x2 by l plus u by l. This is your x1 dot. So let me call this as your equation number 2. So this is very important for us. Is it in the correct format? What is the correct format we want? We want it like x dot is equal to a into x plus u. Your x dot should depend only on x and u. Yes. In your equation to x dot is depending on only on x and u. Other than x and u, l is constant. So other than x and u, you don't have anything else. So keep it x, keep equation 2 as it is. Now what is that one more equation I need to derive to get the state space model? What is state model? State model contains two equations. One is x dot, another one is y. So what is another equation? Y is equal to c into x plus d into u. So now I want to derive one more equation. So how to derive one more equation? So from the circuit, what is output, what is V is equal to from the circuit? In the circuit here, what is V? V is the voltage across the capacitor C. So I can write this as, so I can write this V as voltage across capacitor, voltage across capacitor, which is equal to 1 by C integration current flowing in the capacitor. Current flowing in the capacitor is I2. So now can I write instead of V? V is nothing but the state variable X2. So X2 is equal to 1 by C integration I2 dt. Okay. X2 is equal to 1 by C integration I2 dt. Now you differentiate on both sides. So what happens if you differentiate on both sides? So if you differentiate on both sides, you are going to get it as x small x2 dot is equal to 1 by c I2 into dt. X2 dot is equal to 1 by c I2 dt. Dt will not come because you have differentiated, so this dt term will not come. Now x2 is equal to 1 by c into I2. You know what is I2. I2 from the previous slide, we know that I2 is nothing but I2 expression. I2 is nothing but x1 minus x2 divided by r. So you have derived I2 equation from the previous slide. This is your I2 equation, x1 minus x2 divided by r. That I am substituting here in x2 dot. So now if you substitute, what is that expression you are going to get? X2 dot is equal to x1 by c minus x2 by r c. So let me call this equation as equation number 3. This equation is also important. Why it is important? Okay, till now what is that we want? We want the equations for both the state variables. How many state variables you had? There are two state variables, x1 and x2. Okay. Now I got to know what are the equations for x1 and x2. So x1 dot and x2 dot equations I got to know. So what are the equations for that? Equation 2 is the equation for x1 dot. Equation 3 is the equation for x2 dot. So can I represent that in the form of a matrix form? I'll write down here from the previous, I'll write down what is your x1 dot you got from the previous slide. Your x1 dot is equal to, you got it as minus x2 by L plus u by L. And x2 dot you got it as, it is there only, minus x1 by c, sorry, plus x1 by c minus x2 by rc. These are the equations I got. So from this equation, I am going to write it in the matrix form. So here, LHS I am writing x1 dot x2 dot. RHS I am writing it like, it is like which one? X dot is equal to AX plus BU. So in this format I am writing. So A is the big matrix. Instead of x, I am going to, what is there inside capital X? There are only two state variables in the given problem, x1 and x2, plus b. B is some column vector, and u. U is how many input variables are there in the given problem? There is only one input. Okay, so it is a CISO problem. Single input, single output. So only u I am writing. I should not write like u1, u2, u3. No, only one input is there. So therefore I am writing only u. Now I have to fill inside this matrix by looking into the equation. So what is there in the equation? Is there any x1 term present in the x1 dot equation? First equation number 2. No, x1 term is not there. Because x1 term is not there, what you should substitute in place of x1? X1 is the first element. So you should substitute here it as 0. So your element will be 0. Now is there any x2 term present in the first equation? First equation contains x2. What is there with x2? Minus 1 by L. That minus 1 by L, x2 is the second place. So here you should substitute minus 1 by L. Minus 1 by L. Now come to the second equation. Now in the first equation only, see in the first equation only, after x1 and x2, you have plus u by L. U by L, plus is there, so I am writing plus here. U is there, and along with u, what is multiplied? 1 divided by L, correct. So with u, what I should multiply for the first equation? 1 divided by L. So here in the first element, you should get 1 by L. So you should write here as 1 by L. Now come to the second equation. Second equation means x2 dot is equal to x1 by c, x2 by rc. So with x1, what is multiplied? 1 divided by c. So x1 is the first element. So in the second row, first element, what you should substitute? 1 divided by c. Here you should substitute 1 divided by c. And in the second row, second element, what you should substitute? Second row, second element. This is second row, second element. Second row, second element. This is your second row, second element. Minus 1 by RC. So you substitute minus 1 by RC. Minus 1 by RC. And do you have any input term present in the second equation? X2 dot is equal to X1 and X2. Do you have any U term? U means input term. No, I don't have any input term at all. So plus input should not come. So input should not come means for the second row after plus sign, for the second row u should not come. So I should multiply u with 0, right? So I have to put 0 here. So I have to put 0 here. Okay, so one equation you got. So now this equation is looking like x dot is equal to ax plus bu. And I should get one more equation. Now what is that one more equation you should get? Y is equal to cx plus du. I should also find out what is this equation. For that you write down what is the output. What is output? Output is nothing but ix. Okay, in the problem they have given that you should take ix as output. Ix is equal to what? It is equal to, in the circuit you can refer the circuit. In the circuit what is ix? Ix is the current in the resistor R. Ix can be written as I1 minus I2. Correct, no? Ix can be written as I1 minus I2. That you substitute now here. So Ix can be written as I1 minus I2. Now what is I1? I1 is the inductor current. I1 you have taken it as state variable x1. What is I2? I2 you have derived in the previous step, x1 minus x2 by r. You have derived it, x1 minus x2 by r. Now if you simplify, x1 x1 cancel and you are left with plus x2 by r. So this is your ix. And instead of ix, what can I write? Because ix is output, I can write it as y. Now can you write this in the matrix form? Y is equal to some column vector. Why I am writing only single y instead of capital Y? Because it is a single output system. Output contains only one variable. That's why only one y I am writing. Okay, so now I have to multiply. It should be like this form. In this form, y is equal to cx plus du. Okay, so x is what? How many state variables you have? Two. x1 and x2. Okay, now what you should multiply here to get this answer? x1. Is your y containing x1 equation? No, it does not contain any x1 term at all. So I have to put x1 means first element. So first element should be 0. First element should be 0. Now does your y contains x2? Yes. x2 is multiplied by 1 divided by r. x2 is the second element. So substitute the second element with 1 divided by r, which is a constant. 1 divided by r. Okay, now plus anything will come? No. Why? Because your y equation contains only x2 term, x2 by r, plus something into u. It does not contain any u term. Y depends only on x2. It does not depend on u. So therefore u will not come. Okay, that means your d after c into x plus d into u, this d term is completely zero. Capital D is completely zero. Okay, because your y depends only on x in the given problem. Y does not depend on u. U means input. So it will not come. So this plus sign will not come. So this equation, whatever you derived now, till now, this equation and this y equation is called as state space model. Okay, this only they asked in the problem to find out. This is only called as state space model, or simply you can call it as state model. Now how to write the diagram, signal flow graph, SFG? How to write the signal flow graph? Now how you will get output y? You should always start writing the signal flow graph from the reverse way. Y is equal to what? Y is equal to x2 by r. So assume that you have x1 and x2 here. So assume that this is your x2 and this is your x1 and this is your input u. So how to interconnect now? What is y? Y is equal to x2 divided by r. For x2 you have to multiply 1 by r. Then only you are going to get y. Now how to get x2? So how to get x2? See, here you have derived the equation for x2 dot. x2 dot is there. How to get x2? Take dot to the other side. Dot means differentiation. If you take differentiation to the other side, this becomes integration, right? So x2 is equal to integration x1 by c minus integration x2 by rc. Okay, so that I will write here once again just to show you. x2 is equal to integration. x2 is equal to integration x1 by c minus integration x2 by rc minus integration x2 by rc. Now if you take Laplace transform on both sides, what is it you will get? Capital X2 is equal to integration means 1 by s, c is as it is x1 minus Laplace transform of integration is 1 by s and divided by rc is as it is into x2. Now how to draw? So to get x2, you have to take from x1. From x1, you have to multiply 1 divided by sc. And after that, x2 is depending on x2 only. Okay. So for x2, you have to take x2 only. What you have to multiply? Minus 1 by s into rc. How I am writing this? I am writing because of this equation here. x2 depends on x2 only. x2 is 1 by sc into x1, 1 by s into x1 and then minus 1 by s into rc x2. So that is why I have written like a self loop here, because x2 depends on x2 only. So I have written like this. Now after that, how to get x1? Where is x1? X1 dot is nothing but minus x2 divided by l plus u by l. So if you take dot other side, it is integration of x2 integration of u. So I have to write as how to get x1. X1 is directly you have to take input signal. For that input signal, you have to multiply 1 by l and integration. Integration means a s term should come in the denominator. And what is one more term for x1? To get x1, I have to take x2 also. See this equation. To get x1, integrate u and integrate x2. If you integrate x2, then you are going to get minus 1 by sl. So from x2, from this x2, you have to give it to x1. And what you have to write here? Minus 1 divided by ls. Minus 1 divided by ls. Okay. See the arrow mark. The arrow mark for x1, there are two incoming arrow marks. One is from u, 1 by ls. And the other one is from x2, minus 1 by ls. So if you add this u incoming arrow mark and another incoming arrow mark, if you add, then you are going to get x1. And if you take this x1 and x2, then you are going to get x2. And if you take this x2 alone, then you are going to get y. So starting from the input side, I have written the diagram till the output side. So this is your input, this is your output. So I have written a signal flow diagram. I have written a signal flow diagram for the given electrical circuit. I have converted an electrical circuit into state space model. From the state space model, I am writing a signal flow graph.